In this video, we'll be solving a question from the Chinese Math Olympiad. Given the equation p to the q plus q to the p equals r, then find all prime solutions for p, q, and r. Now let's see how to solve one equation for three prime numbers. So let's start from this equation. P to the q plus q to the p equals r. Because the minimum number for a prime number is 2, so that means the minimum number for this part is 2 squared, which is 4. Same is here. So that means for the left-hand side, it's bigger than or equal to 8. So that means for the right-hand side, it's also bigger than or equal to 8. But because r is a prime number, it cannot be 8, so that means it must be bigger than 8. And it's an odd number, because r is a prime number. So that means, since the right-hand side is odd number, so then the left-hand side of the equation is also odd number. So then this implies for p and the q, then one of them is even. Then the other one is odd. So now let's consider the first case. So first case, if p is even, so that means the q is odd. So then p is even, that means p can only be 2. So now let's see q. So let's consider the case if q equals 3. So now let's see the equation. P to the q plus q to the p then equals just 2 to the third, then plus 3 squared, then equals 17. 17 is a prime number. So that means we have a solution of the equation. That means for p, q, and r, so p equals 2, then q equals 3, then r equals 17. So this is the first set of the solution of this equation. Okay, so now let's consider the second case. If q is bigger than or equal to 5, so here, if q is bigger than or equal to 5. So let's start from the equation. So then the equation, p to the q, then plus q to the p. Because p is 2, then 2 to the q, then plus q squared. So then we can reorganize this part. We can put as 2 to the q plus 1. Then q squared minus 1. Then plus 1 minus 1 and cancel out, we still have here. So now let's mark this one with a star. So let's work on this part first. Because q is bigger than or equal to 5, and q is our number. So that means we can let q then equals 2k plus 1. So here, k is a natural number. So now, let's see this part. 2 to the q plus 1. Then for 2 to the q plus 1. So now we can use this part for q. Then here, 2 to the power of 2k plus 1. Then here, plus 1. Then this one is a 2 to the power 2k, then times 2, then plus 1. Then here, just 2 times 2 squared, that's 4. Then 4 to the power k plus 1. Then for 4, we can put as 3 plus 1 to the power of k. n plus 1. Then for this part, we can use a binomial expansion. Then one use binomial expansion, except the last term. So each term including the factor of 3. So that means 1 is divided by 3, so its remainder only depends on the last term of the expansion. So then here, the remainder 1 divided by 3, just 2 times the last term, 1 to the power of k, n plus 1. Then here equals 3, then the remainder is 0, 1 divided by 3. So that means 2 to the q plus 1 is divisible by 3. So then means 3 divides this part. So 2 to the q n plus 1. So let's label this one as result 1. So now let's look at this part. So q squared minus 1. Because q is bigger than or equal to 5, and the q is a prime number. So that means q is not divisible by 3. So that means q, it has a remainder 1 or 2. 1 is divided by 3. Then for q squared, 1 squared is 1. 2 squared is a 4. So then 1 and 4, it has a remainder 1. 1 divided by 3. So this means just q squared minus 1 is divisible by 3. So then here means just 3 divides q squared minus 1. So let's label this one as result 2. So now let's combine result 1 with result 2. So result 1 means, so 3 divides 2 to the q plus 1. So then here, just 3 divides 2 to the q plus 1. Then from the result 2, so that means 3 also divides q squared minus 1. So then 3 divides the sum of these two. So now let's see here. So positive 1, negative 1 canceled. So then we have 2 to the q, then plus q squared, which equals r. So that means 3 divides r. So then we have a just a result of 3 divides r. But because r is bigger than 8, and r is a prime number, and r is a prime number, so that means this is simply impossible. So that means this result simply impossible. So this implies, for this equation, 2 to the q plus q squared equals r has no solution. One, if q is bigger than or equal to 5. So that means for the first case, it has only one solution. So now let's see case 2. Case 2 is if just q is even. Then since in the case 1, there's only one solution, so then by the symmetry, of p and the q, so that means the solution for p, q, and r, just simply swap p and q from the solution in case 1. So then here, this time, q is 2, then p is 3, then r is still 17. So now let's combine. So this is solution in the second case. So now let's combine the solutions in case one and the case two. So then we have the solutions for P, Q, and R. The first one just P is a 2, Q is a 3, R is 17. Then the second case, just swap these two. Then P is 3, then Q is a 2, then R is 17. So that means there are two prime number solutions for this equation. Thanks for watching.